Short films are usually much more detailed than their longer counterparts, as there's more attention paid to smaller details and shots. The story still takes center stage, but it's supported by other elements that further enhance the narrative. Wes Anderson's 2007 film Hotel Chevalier is a great short film and a prequel to his previous feature film The Darjeeling Limited. The focus of the film is examining the relationship between Jack and Natalie Portman's nameless character through their actions rather than through dialogue. If you haven't seen the film, I suggest you pause here and come back when you have, since there'll be some minor spoilers. The first few scenes reveal Jack's character. We're introduced to a messy hotel room, a hint that he's been living here for a while. Then we cut to Jack, who's dressed in a yellow bathrobe, which makes him seamlessly blend into the yellow room around him. He orders some food in French, but then has to switch to English. Another hint that while he tries to blend in, you can get the idea that he doesn't belong here. Then we're introduced to Natalie Portman's character over the phone. She wants to see Jack, and while Jack is initially reluctant, he agrees to let her come over. He then springs into action and cleans the room meticulously, setting up various items for her arrival. He even selects a song to play when she arrives. There's a quick time jump, and just before her arrival, we see Jack on the bed again, this time in a formal suit, which sets him in stark contrast with the yellow room. Instead of blending in as before, he now stands out, further emphasizing that he doesn't quite belong here. Jack starts the music when Portman appears at the door. The camera's position makes Jack imposing on Portman, asserting a sense of power. However, as Portman explores the room, it becomes clear that she's the more dominant one in the relationship. She was, after all, the one who pushed to come over in the first place, and she later uses Jack's toothbrush and asks him to order her a drink. But back to the music for a second. The song's main chorus, "I Want to Look Inside Your Head," pretty much sums up both characters' motives, as this is exactly what they're trying to do. Jack is trying to make it seem like he can live without her, and Natalie Portman's character is examining the room to see what he's been doing while they've been apart. Take a look at the previous scene beside this one. Before her arrival, the room is a complete mess, and when she arrives, the items are nicely organized as if on display. He's trying to show off a version of himself that doesn't exist. Eventually, Portman asks,
"What the fuck is going on?"
And Jack reveals that he's had this hotel room for a while, and that he's been trying to run away from her. While it's not revealed why they broke up, we can guess that it wasn't mutual and that she was the reason for the breakup. This is confirmed later on, but we'll get to that. The food Jack ordered arrives, but as soon as the waiter leaves, the two get intimate. It's important to note what happens here. Jack never loosens a button on his suit, but completely undresses Portman, which reveals her bruises. Jack asks about them.
"You got bruises on your body."
But it's quickly forgotten about. In fact, Jack shows very little emotion the entire time he's with her. It's not about the intimacy for him. It's more of a show that he doesn't need her. Portman's character as well reveals that she doesn't necessarily care about Jack, as she says,
"We fuck, I'm gonna feel like shit tomorrow."
And later, when Portman says,
"I love you. I never hurt you on purpose."
Jack remains completely flat and simply responds with,
"I don't care."
In the end, they don't get any more intimate than this. Neither one of them really wants this relationship, but they keep trying to force it anyway. Instead of continuing, Jack offers her a chance to see his view of Paris. Anderson, of course, employs one of his now infamous slow-motion tracking shots as the music plays in the background, again highlighting the theme of their meeting. However, their attire is reversed as Portman puts on Jack's yellow robe. Now she blends into the room while Jack remains juxtaposed with it. She's a part of his past, a past he no longer belongs to. On the balcony, this theme is reversed again. Now Jack blends into the blue and gray skyline while Portman stands out, again showing us that they belong to different worlds and not with each other. The camera pans to his view of Paris, which is amusingly nothing more than a facade of another hotel. And like the main characters, it's a front which hides who they really are. One final note is the name of the film itself. Chevalier is French for knight, more specifically, a heroic knight. Ironically, Jack is anything but that, as he's been hiding it from conflict with his ex to the point where he has in some way become a damsel in distress, locked away from the world in a hotel room. Overall, it's a great short story combined with Anderson's signature cinematography, but it's also much more than that. I like to think that Hotel Chevalier is in some way about how relationships work, with one or both parties trying to convince the other of something while simultaneously trying to see what they're thinking. While this can work, it fails when what they present is simply a facade of their true selves. Both partners can try to make the relationship work, but in the end, the result is that they just can't force themselves to be together. Hey guys, Hotel Chevalier is one of my favorite short films. Do give it a watch if you haven't already. And if you like this video, be sure to tap the like and subscribe button as well. Also, check out some of my previous videos in the SFP playlist. I promise they won't be as critical on relationships as this one was. And as always, thanks for watching.